Jennifer Gill from Western Kentucky University, and today I'm going to be talking about a study that Gabriella Lynn completed, which is titled The Evaluation of Hoof Pressure, Contact Area, and Force Using Fujifilm in the Booted and Shod Horse. And she wrote up this study for the International Canine and Equine Locomotion Conference, which is being held in Switzerland this year. I want to recap a little bit on our 2018-2019 results, which I've also presented in a bit more detail in another video presentation. We found that the Cavallo Trek Hoof Boot was better at distributing and absorbing pressure on hard terrains than when the horse was barefoot. We didn't find much of a difference on softer terrain, so in this research, we wanted to just focus on a hard terrain, which we chose asphalt for this study. We also want to look at other things like surface area and force in addition to pressure. We like the fact that the Cavallo Trek Hoof Boot did protect the entire hoof itself, which we thought was very beneficial, especially over some other types of hoof protection like horseshoes. We also found that the tread of the Cavallo Trek Hoof Boot was thicker and may provide more traction and more space to contact with the ground than a metal horseshoe. And so for this study, we really wanted to compare the Cavallo Trek Hoof Boot to metal horseshoes. So our objective of the study was to determine if the Cavallo Trek Hoof Boot would be more beneficial than a traditional metal horseshoe when the horse steps down onto the ground. And our hypothesis was that the Cavallo Trek Hoof Boot would be more beneficial than the steel horseshoe with equipack pouring pad and then a steel horseshoe itself without a pad. And we wanted to look at pressure and surface area in addition to force for this study. So we used 5 mature geldings and mares again. Our surface was just asphalt. We had 3 treatments being the Cavallo Trek hoof boots, steel horseshoes, and then the steel horseshoe and the pouring pad. We again used low prescale film, the Fuji film from Sensor Products Incorporated, with a detection range of 350 to 1400 PSI. The readout was a pseudo color analysis that allowed us to look at dynamic pressure and that pressure mapping, which was really beneficial to seeing where the pressure forces were happening over the surface of the foot. We decided to try a new method of collection for this study, and we wanted to get that coefficient of variation that I talked about before in an even narrower range. And so we were hoping that with a really narrow range, we would only need 2 replicates per horse. And so we did some pre-study treatment and we found a new method that worked very well. And we had a lot of success with it with this study. So what we would do to collect our hoof prints was to place the film down, pick up the horse's foot, place it onto the film, pick up the opposite front foot, then the horse would shift its weight onto that foot that was in contact with the film. Then we place that opposite foot back down and then pick up the foot that was on the film. And so we found that this was a really good method for getting a hoof print that was very representative of the horse's weight and force on the film. So to talk a little bit more about our method collection, I'm going to show you kind of a pictorial layout of how the prints were collected. So we had 5 horses, which are shown here, and each horse underwent each treatment type. So each horse wore the Cavallo Trek hoof boot, and we collected 2 prints with that on. Then our farrier nailed on the steel horseshoe, and then we collected 2 more prints onto the film. And then a steel horseshoe, then that steel horseshoe was filled with Equipack pouring pad, and then we did 2 more replicates on the film. And so each horse underwent all of these treatments with 2 replicates per treatment type. And our farrier worked very hard that day to collect all of this data in one day, and so did our students. They were really wonderful at moving horses around and getting everything done that day. So to talk a little bit about our statistics and our analyses, we used an ANOVA this time with treatments, the Cavallo Trek hoof boot, the steel horseshoe, and the steel horseshoe with Equipack pouring pad. And we looked at separating the means to compare each of them using Tukey's multiple comparison analyses. I want to talk a little bit about our results. So to start off, we're looking here at mean pressure and our three treatment types. And we found that the Cavallo Trek hoof boot was significantly lower in pressure than the other two treatments. And this is what we expected from our data. So we would have expected that the Cavallo Trek hoof boot would have been lower than our steel horseshoe and a steel horseshoe with Equipack, especially on a hard terrain. And this was good news for what we were expecting to see. And we did find that the steel horseshoe and the steel horseshoe with Equipack were very similar in their measures throughout this study. It wasn't a huge difference between them. So now we're looking at the mean surface area in square inch, and we found that the contacting surface area from the Cavallo Trek hoof boot was significantly higher than the other two treatments. This was also what we were hoping for and what we expected to see. There was more tread that was in contact with the ground than would be with the steel horseshoe and the steel horseshoe with Equipack. We think that the steel horseshoe with Equipack, we didn't see much of an increase in surface area with that because of the fact that it was a hard terrain, and I don't think the Equipack was in contact with the surface. Maybe on a softer terrain, you would have more contact with the Equipack forearm pad and the surface that the horse was walking on. So based on this result, we would say that horses would have better traction in the Cavallo Trek hoof boots and be better able to dissipate those forces and pressure because of the increase in surface area. So next we looked at the mean pound force of the Cavallo Trek hoof boot, the steel horseshoe plus Equipack, and then the steel horseshoe itself. We found that the Cavallo Trek hoof boot exhibited higher force than the other two treatments. This was a little bit unexpected, but nothing major. It's possible that the acceleration of the hoof boot and the film was just higher. Maybe the horses didn't get accustomed to the boots quite as well as with the horseshoes. We did try to walk the horses around after putting the boots on and after nailing the shoes on, but it's just possible that there was more acceleration when the horse took a step down in the Cavallo Trek hoof boot than with the other two treatments. And so this is just something that we're going to note, but it doesn't make a big difference on the other two results that we saw. So in conclusion, horses ridden on hard surfaces may benefit from a Cavallo Trek hoof boot to mitigate damage to the foot, and we found this to be very positive and confirm our other results with barefoot horses, but now we're also looking at other forms of protection. And so again, our Cavallo Trek hoof boot is looking to be the more positive outcome and more positive choice. So you might have a few questions for us, and so we've written some of those out and tried to answer them for you. So the first question is, have you seen validation of these results outside of this study, out in the world, maybe our own horses or others? We have used Cavallo hoof boots successfully with our horses at Western Kentucky University, especially when they lose a horseshoe or are barefoot during turnout and have sensitive feet. We only do arena riding with our horses, so they mostly encounter soft terrains while being ridden. And so since we don't trail ride them or ride them on rugged terrains, we don't have to worry a lot about foot damage. And so we don't have as much of a need of using the Cavallo Trek hoof boots when the horses are being ridden. However, we do recommend them for people that do a lot of trail riding or riding on the roads. Question two is, are you aware of any similar studies being done? And we are not aware of any studies being done to examine dynamic pressure or forces on the foot using hoof boots. However, there have been studies done in the past that have looked at forces on the foot using a force plate. However, force plates are expensive. They don't show that dynamic pressure and the pressure mapping that our Fujifilm product was able to show us. And so we feel like the research that we're doing is very novel because we're able to really look at where the forces are happening on the foot. And then we're also looking at hoof boots as an alternative method of dissipating those forces that are coming in contact with the foot. And so we feel like this is really novel in this area. Fujifilm has been used in assessing saddle fit by manufacturers. And so we do know that this film has been used in horses looking at saddle fit, at least so far. Question three, so has this prompted any further questions from you? And I think we will continue to study the effects of hoof health, perhaps in a study looking at the more long-term use of the hoof boot in horses, and we're going to try to evaluate maybe our prediction of better soundness in horses. And so maybe we'll use the hoof boots and some client-owned horses and see if we can get similar results in the public. So to wrap everything up, we believe that hoof health is very important to the athletic horse's career, and taking the best care of a horse's feet is of primary importance. We really do stress that, that it's so important to take very good care of your horse's feet for them to live happy, sound lives. And hoof boots may play a vital role in achieving soundness in the athletic barefoot horse. And so it's definitely an option that's available to horse owners out there and can be very good for those horses that are ridden on harder terrains. Thank you all so much for listening, and I really hope you have a great day.